In this video, we will discuss a new matter-heuristic optimization algorithm named as Hunger Game Search Optimization Algorithm. As we have already discussed, matter-heuristic algorithms are inspired by natural phenomena, animals, insects, birds' behavior in real life, and other inspiration like biology, humans' behavior, physics-based, and chemistry-based optimization algorithms. Matter-heuristic algorithms mimic living things' behavior, foraging strategies, and their activities. We can use matter-heuristics in different fields to solve different optimization problems, like to solve complex operation research problems, to solve engineering and design problems. In machine learning, we can use matter-heuristics for feature selection, extraction, deep neural network training, clustering, data mining, image processing, signal processing, and other. So here we have a new matter-heuristic algorithm, that is Hunger Game Search Optimizer. This algorithm is inspired by the animal's behavior in state of starvation that we will try to understand now in this algorithm step by step using different examples. First of all, as you can see here, Hunger Game Search Optimizer is introduced in 2021. It is a population-based matter-heuristic optimization algorithm that we can use to solve different optimization problems. This algorithm is tested on 23 different benchmark test functions, and it is also applied to solve engineering design problems. And when this algorithm is compared with 9 different optimization algorithms, it provides efficient results. So we can use this algorithm to solve optimization problems. Now we will try to understand how this algorithm is working. So as you can see here, Hunger Game Search Optimizer is inspired by the animal's behavior in state of starvation. In context of animals, starvation is described as a condition where animals have lack of food or no food for their survival, and sometimes that can cause death. Hunger Game Search Optimizer simulates this animal's behavior in state of starvation. So as this algorithm is inspired by the animal's behavior in state of starvation, so first we will try to understand what is hunger, what is starvation, hunger game in nature, animals' behavior in state of starvation, so that we can easily understand how this algorithm is working step by step. First, what is hunger? Why we eat? We all need balanced diet to stay active throughout the day for movements, growth, and for all body functions like breathing, digestion, and other. Beside hunger, there are several other factors we choose food. For example, you can see here different factors like emotions, medical condition, quality, variety, and other. As we know, hunger is a state of discomfort or craving that is caused by lack of food, but we do not always eat when we are feeling hungry. We also choose food due to different factors. First factor, personal taste. It means we like the way food tastes. For example, we do not eat oranges because they boost our immune system, but we eat because they are juicy and they have excellent flavor. Second factor, favorite food. We all have favorite food, and that is hard to skip even if we are not feeling hungry. So next factor, we have traditional food. When we are out of home for study, work, or during traveling, we have to consume what is offered. Other factors like social pressure, like family pressure to eat vegetarian or non-veg food. Medical factors, if you're going through any health issue, you have to eat accordingly. It is important to distinguish between acute hunger and chronic hunger. Acute hunger is the temporary hunger between the meals, and chronic hunger when we have no food for a long time period. Last factor, we have emotions, like people like to eat when they are bored. not feeling hungry, but they are bored, so they will eat something. Or during any celebration, they are happy. During any party and other. So we choose food due to multiple factors. Even we are not feeling hungry, so we have chronic hunger and acute hunger. Acute hunger, that is the temporary feeling for eating something according to mood swings. Now we will try to understand this algorithm simulation. So lack of food or no food for a long period can cause starvation, disease, and even death. Worldwide, around 828 million people go to bed hungry each night, and around 3 billion people cannot afford healthy diet. So be grateful for what you have in your life, no matter how hard it is. Always be grateful and enjoy little things. Hunger Games Search Optimizer is inspired by the animal's behavior in state of starvation. Now you can see here we have different animals' behavior. So first we have food search. In order to survive in wild, animals must engage in foraging and explore food without exposing to danger. Next we have defense. When exploring food in wild, they must be aware of predators around. In order to survive in wild, animals adopt different strategies for foraging, hunting. Animals regularly search for food in the wild for their survival. So they adopt different strategies for hunting, food foraging, and feeding. Next factor we have territories. Animals define their territories, like you can see in the Gray Wolf Optimizer. And the next factor you can see here, migration and mating. They migrate to different places, and this behavior you can see in the Gorilla Troop Optimizer and in the Elephant Herd Optimizer. So here you can see different animals' behavior. Food search, when they are searching for the food, when they are searching for the food in the surrounding, and they are also aware of the danger. They adopt different foraging strategies, hunting strategies. Then we have the territories. They define their territories. They define their territories, migrate to different places, and they mate and they migrate to different places. In Hunger Games Search, animals' foraging behavior and their activities are simulated in state of starvation. As you can see here in the food chain, how energy and nutrients transfer from one organism to another in the ecosystem. Food chain plays important role in maintaining the balance and functioning of the ecosystem. Imbalance in the food chain can have large impact on the ecosystem. So here you can see the energy transfer, like their food they consume. So in the wild, they have to search for the food every day, and they apply different strategies to stay alive in the wild. So if any animal fails to get food for a long time period, it causes starvation, which can cause even death. So starvation mainly occurs in the winter season. So hunger and craze, foraging and environment exploration, that is the algorithm inspiration. As hunger is considered as the most influenced factor that affect animals' behavior in state of starvation. Stronger the hunger, stronger the craving for the food. When the food sources are limited, there is hunger game between the animals. More healthy and active animal can search best food source in short time period, as starvation can cause death. So animals have to search food in short time period. So healthy animals can find best food source in short time period and win the situation. Hunger and aggression are directly linked. Hunger suppress or influence the fear of hunter. If any animal is hungry and starving, it can enter in the predator territory, and as the animal is starving, they have no fear of hunter. So hunger is the strong motivational force for food searching, learning, activity, learning, and moving. Now, step by step, we will try to understand how this algorithm is working. First, we have two different animals' behavior simulated in this algorithm, cooperative and non-cooperative behavior. Cooperative behavior is often seen in the pack or in the group when animals are hunting in pack or they are protecting each other. And non-cooperative behavior is often seen when there is limited food resources. So these two behaviors are simulated in this algorithm. First, we will initialize the population randomly. Using this equation, we can initialize the position for each agent. Here n, that is the total number of search agent, d, that is the search space dimension. Rand is here an anomaly distributed random number between 0 and 1. Upper bound, lower bound, that is the search space boundary. The new solution that we will initialize, that should be inside the search space. Next we have to check, next we have the stopping condition. We will check the current iteration is less than or equal to maximum iteration or not. For example, we have the current iteration 1, maximum iteration 1000. Right now this condition is true, move to the next step. Now we will calculate the fitness value for each agent. So here we will apply any objective function on the initial population and we will calculate the fitness value for each agent in the current population. The best solution having the minimum fitness value and the worst solution having the maximum fitness value. Next, we will update certain parameters like best fitness value, that is the best solution, WF, that is the worst solution, we can say the worst fitness value among all, and then we have the best agent XB. This represents the hunger of each individual. So here we'll check the all agent fitness value with the best fitness value. If this condition is true, it means animal is not hungry. If this condition is false, it means animals is hungry. And here hungry I, you can see here, this is the older hunger value, capital H, that is the new hunger value, and here in the older hunger we are adding new hunger. Here this is the hunger ratio that depends on the overall food quality and overall search capability for the food. Here you can see the limits that represent the hunger level, lower bound, that means the minimum, upper bound means maximum. Next we will calculate W1 and W2, that which represent the weight of hunger. W1 and W2 is also used to prevent algorithms stuck in the local optima. So now we will calculate the weights for hunger using W1 and W2. Hungry I, that is the hunger value that we calculated for each individual. Then we have S, hungry, that is the sum of all hungry feelings for the all individuals. R3, R4, that is the random values, and small l is the user defined parameter used to improve algorithm. Next we can calculate W2 using this equation. So here you can see hungry, this is the hunger value that we calculated, and then you can see the sum of all hunger, and then we have the random values. Next for all agents we will calculate the parameter E and R. E, that is used for the vibrational control of all positions. R ensure the exploration at the large scale. Here you can see we can calculate the value for E using this equation. Here this is the hyperbolic function, Fi, that is the fitness value for the agent, VF, that is the best fitness, capital value for R can be calculated using this equation, shrink value for shrink. Now here you can see the value for shrink we can calculate using this equation, that is 2 into 1 minus current iteration divided by maximum iteration. So value for R is gradually decreasing to 0. Suppose we have the current iteration 1, maximum iteration 10, then the shrink value we have now have for the first iteration 1.8, then up to last iteration we will got 0. So value for R is gradually decreasing. Next we will update. So when we will calculate the value for ER, you can see here value for E is used here and R is used here. After that, we will update the position for each agent. So here the animal's behaviors are simulated, cooperative and non-cooperative. For non-cooperative behavior, when the agent will randomly search without any cooperation. So we have first non-cooperative behavior. So non-cooperative behavior is calculated using this equation, where the animal is searching randomly without any cooperation with the other animals. And here you can see this is a new position, older position, random value, normally distributed between 0 and 1. Next we have the cooperative behavior that we can calculate using this equation. Check the value for random number with E. If condition is true, update using this, else using this. And here you can see hunger factor we have. And here you can see hunger factor. We have W1, W2, best solution, X best, R that is gradually decreasing to 0, XT that is the older solution. Then we will increment the counter, that is the current iteration plus 1. And then we will repeat the loop until the stopping criteria is met. And in the end, we will display the best solution. First, we'll initialize the population for each agent, then calculate this. Then check the stopping condition, calculate the fitness values, update parameters like best, worst, agent. As we have the virtual environment, virtual agent, so we have virtual hunger values. Calculate hunger, then we will calculate the bait, hunger bait, and then we will update their position in the search space. And after that, we repeat the loop until the stopping condition is met. And when the stopping condition is met, stop and display the best solution. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.